Okay, a short video just to explain the inside of one of these trigger assemblies. Sometimes what can happen is the gun can jam and won't close off properly. So when you let go of the lance or whatever, the water's still coming out the end. So basically, if this is your gun here, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 screws to undo. Okay, then this splits open. Just this plastic casing comes apart like so, giving this part here, and with the mechanism everything happens inside here. Okay, so we sell these as a single item. We also sell this little repair kit for the inside of it. So what usually happens is, in most cases, it's usually a little metal filing or something off one of the couplings, or a bit of dirt or debris. And what happens is, when you take this out, you'll see a spring and a ball bearing. So when you pull the trigger in, this little piston lifts the ball bearing off the seat, and when you let go of the trigger, the spring pushes the ball bearing back onto the seat and seals it. But what you'll find is a little metal filing or something has caught inside there and is stopping the ball bearing sitting on the seat. Okay, so let's just go right ahead and just split this on down. Hold on, I get a wee. Okay, so this little pin comes out there, that comes off. Sorry about that. So get something with a pointy tip on it, and that will push right through. And that's your pin. So basically all you're trying to figure out is what is stopping the thing from sealing. You'll see there's two ends to this, one with a little dentation where the ball bearing sits on, and the thicker bit, so that just pushes through. The thicker bit is the bit that sits against your lever, so that just goes into that, push that back in. Ball bearing sits in there. That sometimes what you also find is you might get a little spur o-ring that has been put in accidentally during manufacture. Just a matter of just plucking it out, putting it back together again. But anyway, that's just really all there is to the insides of one of our trigger assemblies. So working with any of this does take a little bit of patience, which sometimes I don't have. So that's your trigger. That's the way it should feel. You should feel it, you know, going in. What you can do is, before you put it all back together again, if you just blow on the bottom like this, and you'll hear it closing off, rather than putting the whole thing back together again, putting your 7 screws in and going, uh-oh. So, okay, so that's pretty much it. You'll see when you're putting this back together, the plastic casing, you'll see two little spuds on either side, so it just sits down into this little casing here. So put that in, okay. Make sure that's sitting in snug. Put this back on, and there's, that should sort of click together. Click it together, first of all, with your hand. Okay, and then just put your screws back in. I have this little ingenious tool which just
saves a lot of time.
That's it, folks.